One of the key parts to prevent the transmission is to not touching your face. Okay, I was trying to fake it, but I accidentally licked my finger, so I have to wash my tongue. Feel safe. You probably know this by now that touching your face is very bad for transmission virus. Even those health officials couldn't stop licking their face, like this guy and this guy. So let's invent some technology to help. So here's the idea. We're gonna use this little IR sensor and install it around here. And when my hand is crossing this area, anywhere from mouth and nose, it will trigger something. To demonstrate how effective this product is, we need to gather some data. So I plan to add this little 7 segment that triggers how many times I touch my face before and after. Let's find out! Realized I couldn't really see the display. That feels like a failure. Wait, so it's not detecting some of the touches? Let's look at the sensor closely. There's one IR emitter and IR receiver. It works basically by reflecting the IR. And that's gonna light up this indicator. So that's basically telling you it detected something. There's also one potentiometer to adjust the range. If we turn it all the way down, that's basically not detecting anything. When you turn it all the way up, it turns always on. So I'm having like 6.5 centimeters range. If it's a white paper, the range is 11 centimeters. I wouldn't call the manufacturer liars since they set up to. I mean, they probably find something like really hard to find unicorn material to test this with. Well, that's how they tricked you to buy their stuff. Shame. We could add more of this on our contraption. Another way is to pick a different sensor such as this ultrasonic HCSR04. However, it's a little overkill. It actually can tell how far away the item is versus this is just telling the presence. In our application, we really don't need this distance information. So I adjusted the sizes and moved those sensors pointing down like this, and also adding two other sensors on the bottom. Test time. Let's see if we want to do this side. So this module is confirmed dead. We have to replace and continue on. Okay, we're back to business with a little blue color. Is it trying to tell me something? So I tested a lot of things and couldn't fix the display. So just left it for a couple hours and they are back. I feel like the problem is caused by the sweat, because I have the back of the module exposed here. Before we print any useless plastic into this world, maybe we should hot glue it.
It looks a bit ugly, but it does work. You can also see the sweat collected here.
By watching the previous video, I realized there's a lot of interference from the environment. So I have this heat shrink tube to cover the LEDs. I realized the key flaw for this system doesn't work with Face ID. Let me show you here. When the green LED is on, that means it detected something. And when I unlock my iPhone, that's when the Face ID is trying to scan. I don't see any way to fix that. The code is also edited, so it only takes one measurement if you have really fast touching. Since we have four sensors and we don't care which one being triggered, I was thinking how to combine the inputs. Here's what I built using four NPN transistors. You can think of it as four switches in series. In the end, I have to give up this idea. And you know, you can save all this component, the energy lost, and the space just by using software. I also decided to upgrade the display from the 7 segment to the OLED, mainly because it's smaller and it could be much cooler. And after verifying all the connections on a breadboard,
I designed an extra board to clean them up. After many months of redesign, prototyping, and development, here are all the final parts to be built. So this could work as a strain relief mechanism, so we won't yank the cable out. I do have this piece that's designed with some flexibility, so it can fit this rack piece here. So it can be adjusted in this direction, and also slide up and down like this. To connect all the wires, I do have a lot of elaborated design wire guides. I spent a lot of time trying to make this device work for all the heads on the earth. That's why all the joints can be adjusted. And here are the smallest and biggest size it can fit. To add more detail, I customized designed all this water slide decals. This small QR code actually works. On the display side, I added a customized font to fit the sci-fi style, but realizing it's not monospaced, which means the digits shift around all the time, I had to add it to the font file to make sure it's sharing the same space, and also added the leading zeros for the smaller numbers. One benefit for using OLED is you can use customized graphics. It displays the stop sign and also shows a little arrow to indicate which sensor is triggered.
Okay, it's not that much of damage, but it does remind me I'm doing something wrong. Of course, we can intensify this hitter with something like nails.
Oh, it's just really, oh my gosh. What are you, Dr. Xavier? Are you trying to talk to the mutants?
Is it checking my temperature to see if I have COVID or not?
What am I looking at up there? 065? Is it an IQ thing? Look, you can get your IQ immediately. Just put this on and like show the world. Like, oh my god.
That's awesome.
See, what are you doing just now? You're touching your face. So with this device, when you touch your face,
does it just hit your head? Is that all that it does?
If I touch my face, yeah. Oh my god! Did you give like electrical shock or something? Ah, I think it has to be a little more painful. Put spikes on there, like start bleeding. Like, oh god, I touched my face again. Can you have something a little more invasive, like it goes to your Apple Watch and there's an app and it will give you how many times you touch your face today? It's like, Wait a minute, so the machine can touch my face, but you can't.
So based on preliminary research, this device can bring down the touch numbers to 50%, which is a huge success. Of course, you can find all the flaws in our testing. Other than the original design intent, this device can also help you cure your phone addiction. Get you better table manners. Enforces social distancing.
What does your wife think of this?
And keep you stay at home. Again, this is kind of a useless project, but hopefully it makes you laugh. Thanks for all my Patreons for supporting, and if you like the video, please subscribe, thumbs up. Thanks for watching, and happy making!